Good morning, my dear students. Welcome you all to this session. Today's class, we are going to continue exercise 11.4. You can take page number 226 in your NCERT textbook. So this exercise is fully based upon application oriented problems, right? Though here we'll be fully concentrating on the application oriented problems. So here they have given you a word problem. We are supposed to solve that. What is the fifth problem? A path 1 meter wide is built along the border and inside a square garden of size 30 meter. Then find the area of the path. Then find the cost of planting grass in the remaining portion of the garden at the rate of rupees 40 per meter square. So there is a path along the border. So what is the shape of that garden, children? Actually, that garden is in square shape. Okay, that garden is in what shape, children? Square shape. And there is a path 1 meter wide is built along the border. So over inside this this garden, there is a path 1 meter wide. So here also 1 meter, here also 1 meter, here also 1 meter. Okay, the shape of the garden is in what shape? It is in square meter shape. Okay, next, what it is given then? Next concept is, see, 1 meter wide is the path of the garden. So what is the side of this garden? 30 meter. So here also 30 meter, here also 30 meter, here also 30 meter. Okay, so what we should find, children? We should find the area of this path, which means this shaded region. We should find this area. How you will find this area, shaded region, how you will find it? You will find the area of this big region and area of the small region, and if you subtract these two, you will get the area of this path. Then after that, you should find the cost of planting grass. Okay, so first, what are all the things they have given? What is given first? Side of a square garden. This big square garden side is given. Square of a square garden is 30 meter. So what will be this overall area, full area? Area of the square garden is equal to side into side square units. What is side actually? 30 into 30. 30 into 30, 3 threes are 9, 900 meter square is the area of this full square. Now we should find the area of this inside square, right? How you first you want this side, correct? So from this to this, it is 30, means this one, what is thing? If I subtract 1 centimeter this side, 1 centimeter this side, 2 centimeter, if you subtract from 30, you will get 28 meter, which is the side of this length. Okay, did you understand? This is the whole value, 30 centimeter. If I subtract this 1 centimeter in this side and 1 centimeter in this side, 2 centimeter totally I am subtracting. So I get 28 centimeter, which is the side of this inside square. Okay, so I've got the what we got, side of the square inside. Side of the square inside is how much? 28 meter. So what will be the area of the square inside? Area of the square inside is equal to side into side square units. What is side? 28 into 28. 8 8s are 64, 8 2s are 16, 16, 22. 64, 8 2s are 16, 22, 8 2s are 16, 1, 2 2s are 4, 5, 6, 4, sorry children, 4. 8 is 7. 784 meter square is the area of this inside square. Okay, now we want to find the area of the path. Correct? Area of the path, how you will find this walking area alone? How you will find this total area minus the small square inside? Correct? First question, the area of the path is equal to, area of the path is equal to area of the square garden minus area of the square inside. Okay, what is area of the square garden actually? Square garden is 900 meter square. This is 784 meter square. 900 minus 784. You can subtract it. 8 9 1 6 1 1. 116 meter square is the area of the path. So actually we got the area of the path. So now the cost of planting grass in the remaining portion of the garden at the rate of rupees 40 per meter square. So now we are going to plant the grass. Okay, going to plant the grass. We are going to plant the grass in the remaining portion here. This thing only we are going to planting the grasses, because this is your walking area. Overall in this garden, this pencil shaded region is your walking area, which is a path, and inside only we are going to plant the grass. Okay, so for 1 meter square it is 40 rupees. So what is the cost of planting grass? That we should find it. Okay, the cost of planting grass in 1 meter square land is equal to rupees 40. Okay, for 1 meter square land it is rupees 40. So what will be the cost of planting grass in 784 meter square, which is the small square inside, is rupees 40 into 784. 784 into 4, 4 4s are 16, 8 4s are 32, 33, 7 4s are 28, 29, 30, 31. So now rupees 31360 is needed to plant the grasses in that remaining area. So remaining portion is nothing but this pen shaded region, which is the square inside. So it is easy to find the area of the path as well as the how many cost is needed to plant the grass in the remaining portion. Understood? This is your sixth problem, children. It is like example problem what we have discussed previously. So I think so you know this concept. So once again I'm teaching this. Two crossroads, okay, each of width 10 meter, cut at right angles through the center of the rectangular park of length 700 meter, breadth 300 meter. See, one rectangular park is there, children. Keep it in your mind. It is a rectangular park. What is the length and breadth of that park? Length is 700 meter. Breadth is 300 meter. Okay, length and breadth of the rectangular park is 700, 300 meter. Two crossroads are there. This is one road and this is one road. Okay, two crossroads are there. That road width is 10 meter. So this is 10 meter, 10 meter, 10 meter. Width is 10 meter. Okay, that they are parallel to each other, like this parallel lines will be there. This is one road. So I am shading this roads, okay. This is the road, okay. So we are supposed to find the area of this road, this shaded region, we should find it. Also find the park excluding the road. So now then we should find this thing, this area, this area, this area. That and all we should find, excluding the road. Excluding means we should not include this road, and we should find this four partitions. Give the answers in hectares. Then our final answer should be in hectares. So what are the things we should find? we should find area of the road, then we should find area of this rectangular park without roads, then answer in hectares. So three things we should find in this. Okay, now can we find the area of this rectangular park, which is easy. Length, breadth is given, it is easy. So length of the rectangular park is equal to 700 meter. Length of this rectangular park is equal to 700 meter. Breadth of the rectangular park, breadth of the rectangular park is equal to 300 meter. Length it is given, breadth it is given. So can we find the area of the rectangular park? Area of the rectangular park is equal to length into breadth square units. Yes, what is length? 700. Breadth 300. 7 threes are 21, 0000. So your answer is 210,000 meter square is the area of this full rectangle park. This fully they are saying it is 210,000 meter square. Next, you should find the, see I'm naming here, so A, B, C, D. So rectangular park A, B, C, D we have found. Now P, Q, R, S, E, F, G, H. So P, Q, R, S is the road, E, F, G, H is the road. That you know, right? So we should find area of this, area of this. Then we can subtract this from that area of the park. So now, length of the length of the road, length of the road P, Q, R, S. Length of the road PQRS is what, children? What is their length? See, this is 300. So, this is also 300. If this is 300, this length is also 300. Appa 300 meter. So, what will be the breadth? Breadth of the road PQRS is equal to, what is the breadth of this road PQRS? If this is 10 meter, this is also 10 meter. Correct? So breadth is 10 meter. So what will be the area of the road PQRS? Length into breadth. So 300 into 10. 300 into 10. So 3000 meter square units. Okay. So 3000 meter square is the area of the road PQRS. This is the area, this area we are speaking about. Now can we find this area? Yes, now it is easy. Length we should find, right? Length of the road EFGH is equal to, then breadth of the road EFGH. What is length of the road EFGH? Length, what is the length? This is 700 meter. So this is also 700 meter. Yes. So what is the length? 700 meter. Breadth, this is 10 meter. So this is also 10 meter. Our breadth is what? It is 10 meter. So what will be the area of the road EFGH? Length into breadth. What is length here? 700 into breadth 10. Appo 7000 meter square is the area of the road. Now if you want to find the area of the roads, you should add both the roads. Correct? So, see, if you want to find the area of the roads, one thing is there. See, when I add these two together, this region, this shaded region will be repeated two times, will be added two times. So, you should obviously subtract this value, right? So, we can take this as what we can take, K, L, M, N. Okay, so I'm going to find the what is the side of the road? KLMN, because it is square shape. See, this is a square shape. So what will be the side actually? 10 meter. Apo, what is the side of that region? 10 meter. So what will be the road? KLMN, 10 into 10, because side into side, 100 meter square. So when I'm doing finding the area of the roads, we should be careful, right? Area of the roads is equal to what and all area we should add it? PQRS, PQRS, right? Area PQRS plus area EFGH. If I add these two roads, this region is repeated two times. So one time you should subtract it. So minus area KLMN. What is PQRS area? 3000. Right, 3000 only, no? Yes, 3000. PE and EFGH, 7000 minus 100. So what is the answer? 3000. 7000, it is 10000 minus 100, 00, here 0, 91. So here 9900. So 9900 meter square is the area of that roads. Now we should find the area of the what we should find area of this rectangular garden except the roads. Yes, now first we should find this in hectares, because our answers should be in hectares, right? So we should convert this to hectares, right? So 1 hectare is equal, what is the relation between hectare and meter? 1 hectare is equal to 10,000 meter square. So 1 meter square is equal to 1 divided by 10,000 hectare. Correct? How many meter squares you have? 9,900 meter square is equal to 9,900 meter square divided by 10,000 hectare. So how many digit? 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So the decimal point will come here. Exactly will come here. So 0.9900 hectare. Okay, so my area of the roads is how much, children? Area of the roads is equal to 0.9900, or you can write 0.99 hectare. Okay, I got the answer of this roads. Okay, area of the roads is equal to 0.99 hectares. Now what we should find? Area of the rectangular park excluding roads. Okay, area of the rectangular park excluding roads. So how we will exclude the roads, children? From this area of this rectangle, if you subtract the area of the road, you will get this area of the rectangular park excluding roads. Okay, so now area of the rectangular park minus area of the roads. Okay, is this correct? Yes, from this big rectangle, if I subtract that road, you will get the area of the rectangular park excluding roads. What is rectangular park area? 2,10,000 meter square. 2,10,000 minus area of the roads, 9,900 meter square. So 2,100,0099. Okay, 00, here 0. 19 1002. Okay, so answer is 200100m². Okay, now so this is what the area of the rectangular park excluding the roads. Okay, now our answer should be in hectares, right? So what is the relation? 1 hectare is equal to 10,000m². 1m² is equal to 1/10,000 hectare. See, be careful in this relation. So how many meter square we have? 200100m² is equal to 200100/10,000 hectare. How many zeros are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4. You will keep the decimal point here. So 20.01 hectares. Okay, you can write like that. So what will be the area of the rectangular park excluding roads is equal to 20.01 hectares. Don't put meter square, children, because our answers, everything should be in hectares. So be careful while writing this problem. Okay, see children, this is very big problem, but it is easy. Okay, length, breadth, it is given. Using the length and breadth, we have found the area of this full rectangular park. Then we should find the area of the road. So finding length and breadth of this, we found the area of this side, then area of this side, then adding these two, subtracting one region, you will get the area of the roads. After finding area of the roads, we have answered that in hectares. Then area of the rectangular park excluding roads, we have subtracted rectangular park minus roads. You got the area of the rectangular park excluding roads. That also I have converted to hectares. Okay, next is your seventh problem, that is homework, which is very easy, but it is related to this concept. Okay, so you can write that also the same thing, the road, like that only the problem is where you have to find the length and breadth. Okay, but the thing is, after finding the area covered by roads, we should find the cost of that. Okay, that's all. Cost means for 1m² it is given 110 rupees. So how many rupees will come? It is easy. So seventh problem is your homework. I hope you all understood, children. Thank you.